A new study just came out suggesting COVID may hide in the brain, causing a relapse of symptoms in recovered patients. You better take a look at this. Coronavirus. We know this deadly disease wreaks havoc on our lungs and respiratory system, but a new study suggests it goes much deeper than that. After initial symptoms clear, the virus hides in our brains, causing relapses down the road, leading to forgetfulness, brain fog, depression, mania, even speech issues. Does COVID lay dormant in the brain, only to strike again? Is COVID hiding in your brain? And joining us now is neurologist and neuroimmunologist at Yale School of Medicine, Dr. Sharon Stoll. Welcome, Dr. Stoll. Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you. Such a pleasure to be here.
Yeah. You know, Dr. Stoll, this new study, it came out and it's a little worrisome. It suggests that the COVID virus can hide in the brain. So break this down for us.
The study that actually recently came out talks about mice, not human subjects. So as a neuroimmunologist, I treat humans, I treat people, and thank God we actually haven't seen too much evidence of COVID-19 hiding in the brain.
So granted, the study was in mice, but I don't think you can necessarily dismiss it because it did find that COVID was found in the brains of these mice, perhaps at a higher rate than we expected. So it's just something to think about as we do see some of the longer term neurologic effects we're seeing in COVID patients and people.
Sure. The study actually talks about how it can be found in, I think, up to 10 times or 10,000 times more likely in the brain of these mice. And that's just not something that we see in people.
Well, Dr. Stoll, these, quote, relapsing of symptoms with COVID is definitely scary. And, you know, thinking of my microbiology, we know that certain viruses can remain dormant to come back later. We also know there's something called slow viruses, which appear later. So this whole scenario is scary. Explain to us what this means.
That's a great point. As a neuroimmunologist, actually, the most common condition that I treat is multiple sclerosis. So I'm very familiar with relapsing or remitting forms of neurologic illnesses like MS. And with COVID, that's actually not something that we see in terms of new or worsening neurologic symptoms after the initial phase of the illness. Months to years later. Well, we don't really have data on years later because we're still within that first year period. But the study spoke about how initially when somebody gets diagnosed with COVID-19, it starts off as a viral or respiratory infection. And then a few days later, after somebody seems to be getting better, can develop new sets of symptoms. In that case, we actually do see that in reality. The most common thing that I'm sure everyone listening has heard of has been loss of the sense of smell or taste. And that's something that actually doesn't start initially right away, but can happen a week or two after the viral symptoms subside. One of the more concerning neurologic symptoms, however, is something like stroke or other forms of blood clots like DVTs or MIs, heart attacks. And that can happen a few weeks or a few days after the viral prodrome of the illness.